up here, basically you've got the emergency exit to the ladies' toilet.
Right.
Again, this was only added on about less than 10 years ago.
Right, okay.
If you want to keep coming this way. This is where the building gets really old. The fire station actually used to stable the horses down here.
So what was this, the lane or something that's now enclosed?
Yeah, basically all this bit is a false wall. We'll come back to that in a second.
Okay, looking out, it is a rabbit warren, this.
I have been in there drinking before, but I've never actually realised the extent of the rooms at the back. There is actually quite a large pool room. Never noticed that before. Generally when you're drunk you manage to make it to the bar, make it to one of the small back rooms, and that is the limit.
This room's out of use.
Yeah.
You'll probably see stuff in here at the moment that's not going to be here when you next web it.
And that's where the other fire door goes to, because there's two entrances here. Again, it's a split. The building's just made up over hundreds of years of other buildings have merged and had covers put over them.
They've all been added on. Originally, this part of the building, would you believe it or not, it used to be a kitchen years ago.
Wow.
Before then, it used to be a courtyard. Basically, they used to bring the horses from the back lane and bring them up in here. This is where they used to stable.
Right.
We hear a lot of noises coming from this room. A lot of things that can't be explained. You don't have to set the pool walls up, they'll set themselves up.
What?
The pool walls will set themselves up.
So if I left them scattered, come back, they'll form a triangle?
No, the pool balls will be...
In the pockets?
In the table.
Ah, right.
And the pool balls will, all of a sudden, be on the table in a triangle.
Yeah.
You'll hear them break. You've got this wall that's basically been rebuilt.
Okay.
Well, you can see by the line we're here, this is a false wall. This was never here.
Right. So this was the original lane up
this
the side?
This was the original lane.
This is an add-on here on the left.
Much further that way, yeah. You used to have a set of stairs here.
Sorry, my camera's gone really weird. It won't focus on you. There you go.
Wouldn't really surprise me to be in this place. And this is where we get a lot of the things that actually happen. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Yeah?
I just heard that. I do not know what that was. Okay, we'll carry on.
That happens all the time.
Right.
I don't even pay attention to it anymore. It's just like you look around and it's like,
yeah,
okay, that wasn't me.
Upon the prelim, we were going usual baselines of electromagnetic fields, background noise, general stories of the area, what people felt, get a feel of the building itself.
Goes well past three behind up here. We go up to the 100 side of things. As you can see, it's almost off the scale. If we actually move towards the CCTV camera screen that's around the back here.
Yeah, it's just off the scale on 0 to 100.
So this one, if it's this nice steady peak and then just drains away, it usually means there's some sort of anomaly. If it's pulsating, it usually is man-made.
So. I was expecting a higher electromagnetic field around the building, purely because the amount of energy used for the jukebox stereo systems, lighting and so forth.
You see down here, and again the tri-field comes up, that's on 100 range. So we've got quite a lot of magnetic field coming out of that. So coming around here, back to lighting again. Emergency lighting, as we expect, goes up the scale.
EMF levels weren't anything unexpected in a public bar.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Going to the snug. This was...
Pink room, fireman's room.
Yeah. In here, mobile phones die, all sorts of things. Usually probably down to the brickwork, because you can't get signals.
It's a lot lower than I had it before.
Yeah, it's...
very low.
We've got lighting again, but it's DC, low. Aspect of things.
no blips on the merely gas range. Coming into the plasma room, TV, again, quite a substantial electromagnetic field coming through here, but again, it's a cabling. And again, lighting as well.
No blips as of yet.
Right, we've got a slight fluctuation in this corner here. Still quite low, fluctuating.
Yeah.
I wonder what that is.
Originally those like little things on top of the...
These lamps.
Okay.
I don't know last strike or note,
but... Into the back, cigarette machine here, turned off. Not coming up to one. Coming into the small TV room, which is the Rovers room, the blue room. But very low fluctuations. Again, TV, come back around, lighting again. No blips on the handheld.
The property is laid out almost like a rabbit warren. There is doors, there's corridors, there's odd little shapes here and there. As an overall building, very confusing layout.
So we've got the magnets with the doors, and again, they're coming off the scale. They're the fire doors, so they'll be on again.
Cool.
Coming up to the 0-100. Come on quite high, so fluctuations around here. Entrance to the cellar, can't go there as of the moment, but that's dead as well. Gents, sorry for the smell.
Good, I've sucked a bit on.
Yeah, it's not too bad today. Going to the toilet, this is where people have seen it flush.
Yeah.
We've got a fan. Lighting, just got quite high, reading off lights. Pool room. Lighting, picking up. Again, emergency lighting. Inside things. Coming out the gambler. It's quite moist on the ground here.
It's quite damp.
Yeah, coming around. TV again. It's absolutely nothing in here.
Absolutely flat. Are you getting just a bit off the...
A bit off the lighting, that's about it. The only large electromagnetic field that we came across was for one of the security screens on the CCTV, which is a CRT, which is the cathode ray tube equipment, which is like the old big style tellies, which produce a massive amount of EMF. You've got the transformers for the lights, they were producing electromagnetic field as well. And some of the 12 volt converters for light, but they were very localized, easily explained, and easily found and traced.
Having heard a footstep in the corridor behind me, I actually came back from the prelim and spoke with Colin and insisted that a camera was necessary in that area of the corridor, because to get activity of that magnitude on a prelim, we're not looking for spiritual activity, so to speak. We're looking for baseline readings on EMF. We're looking for layout that we can take back to the group so that they know where they're going when they get on the investigation.
After looking at the footage that Steph had got on the prelim, we decided to set up cameras either end of the corridor as a priority. We wanted to be sure that we had the entire corridor covered. Investigators that night were John, Liz, Shelley, Steve, myself, and the manager, Guy.